time to switch gears from politics and hit the open road, whether you drive on the right or the left. So buckle up, check your mirrors, and hit the gas. It's time for Burning Rubber with Ligotti and the Car Doctor.
How come I don't have a cool name? Anyway, AM 950 and 100.3 FM, WROL. You can hear this extremely attractive and smart gentleman every Saturday here for a long time. Saturday mornings, 8:30 to 10. It's called The Car Doctor. Here he's burning rubber. I don't know. Maybe he's just trying to get home quicker. John Paul, welcome.
So how do I look? I have my new turban on with the new ruby in it.
Yeah, I like that. Like the great Karnak.
Yeah. You know, I heard you talking about it on my way in, so well, I thought it.
I didn't know they came in different colors, John.
Yeah, I was a little surprised myself. I'm hoping that, you know, with the Irish holiday coming up, you know, St. Patrick's Day coming up, maybe I can get a green one.
An emerald green one with maybe an emerald in the middle. That would be like the epitome. You could come for a ride with us in the parade. People would love you.
There we go.
All right. Hey, how was your week? Good?
My week was good. You know, I didn't end up in jail, so it's all good.
There you go. I love it. Well, listen, I always fold 220s underneath for bail money anyway in my wallet. So, and David has some on standby, too, and I have his number in case I get really crazy in a weekend. Hey, Cadillac. And again, of course, you know I love Cadillacs.
Yep.
No question. And the Chevy Impala, of course, you know, people that can't afford the big name and all the bells and whistles, it's the same car. The CT6 and Chevrolet Impala has been extended. So people actually like the four-door sedan, it seems.
Yeah. Mary Barra, who's the president of General Motors, you know, when she announced all of her cuts, she said, you know, out goes that Cadillac model, out goes the Impala. And I think she heard from some of their customers and said, you know what? We like the Impala. The Impala is a nice car.
Always
and the
has big, been.
And the four-door Caddy, it sounds nice. We like the Caddy. So, it's kind of funny. I was talking to somebody from Nissan the other day, and they were saying, oddly enough, the younger people, Gen X, Gen Y,
right,
they kind of like sedans. So
right,
just when all the car companies are going towards selling SUVs, you know, some of the younger people as well as some of the older people are liking sedans, and it's surprising who buys some of these products.
And some of the statistics, you know, they have said the Chevy Impala was facing extinction, but at the same time, exactly what you said, it seems that the younger kids who don't, you know, they think of SUVs as, you know, gas-guzzling, climate-changing things. You know, they need a sedan for the family, and we are missing the sedan. You know, when you think about an American sedan, which was always, you know, the old, what would they say, the Chevy, right?
Yeah.
You'd get in the Chevy and you'd go.
Yeah, Chevy, a Buick, a Pontiac, a Mercury, a Ford.
Wow.
You know, and, you know, somebody said to me once, part of the reason is, when I was a kid, my dad had a station wagon. The last thing I wanted was a station wagon.
Right.
People younger than me, when they were kids, their parents had minivans. The last thing they wanted was a minivan.
Right.
Now some of the younger people, they grew up with their parents having SUVs, and they're like, I don't want an SUV.
Right.
That's what my parents drove.
Exactly. I mean, isn't it so weird that we end up like our parents, but we try so hard not to be that, I don't know, it's kind of weird. Now, my car was probably the last year the Cadillac, the 12, that came out with the key in the ignition.
Yep.
But now you have this push-button ignition on cars. And it seems that the Senate liked it after bombshell reports showed that keyless ignition systems have contributed to a rise in accidental carbon monoxide deaths. They say they're pushing for different standards. Now, again, of course, our own Senator Markey and another New England senator, both Democrats from Blumenthal from Connecticut and from New England, they call it the Pocket Act, where they want to make sure that there are standards that if the car isn't moving in a certain amount of time, that it will disengage and, you know, what have you, in case you fall asleep or you come home stone drunk and you can't, I guess, I don't know what that, or in Massachusetts, you can smoke pot legally in your garage before you go and kiss your wife, that, you know, you fall asleep. But again, I don't have a push button thing, so I don't know. Do you like them?
Well, you know, it's one of those things that until you have it, you kind of go, why does anybody care about this? Why does anybody care about a push button start? But in fact, you kind of get used to it after a while. You walk up to the car's locked, you walk up, you grab the door handle, the car unlocks, you get in, you hit the button, you no fumbling for keys. But the problem is, like the same thing at AAA, we probably get 300,000 people a year back into their cars after they lock the keys in them. And when you lock your keys in your car, it's usually because you did one thing a little bit different, and that threw your whole thing off, and you left your keys in the front seat.
Right.
You grabbed that one extra thing, you know, the loaf of bread, the bottle of wine. You forget to hit the off button. You shut the car off. You get out of the house. You go in the house. You drink your bottle of wine. Next thing you know, the car's been running in the garage for an hour and a half, because you never hit the off button to shut it off. And that's where sort of some of the problem happens. And, you know, maybe having some sort of a safety feature that would, after a while, notice that there's nothing going on inside the car, and it's more than just 10 or 15 minutes of the car thawing out on a cold winter morning.
Right.
And it kind of goes, you know what? Nobody's here. Why don't we just shut the car off? 15 minutes of running by itself is plenty. It probably makes some kind of sense, because sometimes we have to do things because people aren't smart enough to do them on their own.
I'll agree with that. And again, my automatic start that came from Cadillac, I can only engage it. It'll be like 10 minutes, and then I can re-engage it.
Yep.
But after that, you got to go out there and put the key in it. But again, I don't know. I don't have one. But I guess it's really increased the amount of accidents. Now, before I get out of the car, being who I am, the large radio talk show host I am, as you notice, I have perfect flat top hairdo. So I'm brushing my hair, you know, in case there were any of my public out there when I get it here to Marina Bay. But I don't know. I have OnStar. So if I get my keys locked, I'm awful sorry. John, I know you work for, but my wife and daughter have AAA, so two out of three ain't bad, right?
No, that's not bad at all. But you know, it's the same thing. And I think one of the first people that left their car running in their garage, oddly enough, was Oprah Winfrey.
No kidding.
Yeah, she like left her Lexus or something running in her garage years ago.
Wow.
And same thing. She got out of her car. She forgot to hit the off button, and I guess her carbon monoxide detectors went off.
Wow.
Which you would think she doesn't even drive
because, no offense. I mean, I'm not being fresh. I'm sure she can't go down to a Shaw's or a Big Y or something and just go shopping. I would just imagine that she would be driven around. But, hey,
Probably when she's in the Hamptons or something, she needs to have, she wants to go out and take her car out.
Right. I mean, you need to go and get some hand-packed vanilla.
Exactly.
Yeah. All right. So, hey, the other thing that I really found, I had three stories for us. You know what's really cool? And, again, I grew up knowing, of course, Motown was not only the great music, but the reason why they call it Motown was it was Motor City, Detroit. Well, it's getting a new Jeep factory. Now, of course, everyone is going, I don't want to get geopolitical here and why it's happening, but the FCA said it would convert the Mack Avenue engine factory to an assembly plant for the next generation Jeep Grand Cherokee. They will invest $4.5 billion, and it's 6,500 new jobs initially. So, I mean, how cool is that to get Motor City? Because that has been devastated since the NAFTA thing and everything. And, of course, Jeep is just a Jeep. I mean, that's you can't get any more American than that.
It really is. And even though, the company's not owned by an American company anymore, we still think of Jeep. We still think of Chrysler as American vehicles. And the idea that They're putting this money into it. They're employing. I mean, there's some really bright people in the Detroit area.
Right.
And I remember back in 2008, I was in Detroit for something. Actually, I was in Dearborn, the next town over where Ford is. There was hundreds of houses that were just sitting empty because all the jobs dried up and everybody moved. Right. And there's, you know, it was good for other parts of the country because these assembly line workers and engineers all went to other places. But still, you look around Detroit now, especially downtown Detroit, it's hard to get a reasonably priced condo in Detroit now because it's starting to come back. And for Chrysler to do this, you know, good for them. That, you know, that's something that really shows that they're putting the money where their mouth is when it says they want to support America.
You know, and again, the Chrysler, the family Chrysler back in the 50s and 60s, I mean, they were just a family car for working class families, kind of like the Ford, you know. And then, of course, you had your upper echelon, your Oldsmobiles, your Cadillacs, your what have you. And, of course, on the Ford side, the Lincolns and the Mercurys. But I'm going to tell you, I love whenever I see, you know, some retooling and whatever and bringing businesses back. Now, I know we talked about AAA. Why don't you tell people, because you can get a lockout, tire changed, all kinds of stuff. Tell people how to get a hold of you, and give a little shove to AAA. Go ahead.
Yeah, AAA. I've been there for 30 some odd years now. People want to get a hold of me besides Saturday morning on the radio, they can always email me at jpaul@aaanortheast.com. AAA Northeast is who I work for. We have offices all over the place, and one of the best services our offices have is you can go to us instead of the Registry of Motor Vehicles, get your driver's license renewed. This weekend at Gillette Stadium, AAA is having their big Travel Marketplace. So I've given away a bunch of tickets on my radio show for Travel Marketplace. Stop on by. You can check out Gillette Stadium, which is worth checking out on its own.
Right.
But then at the same time, there's going to be hundreds of vendors there, and you can go see where you want to go on vacation.
Here he is, the car doctor, our own guru here every Wednesday at 5:15, burning rubber. John Paul. I'm married, but I still love you anyway, buddy.
Thanks, Joe.
All right, bye-bye.
All right, I'll be in next week. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye now.